Yeah, so this is the part two version of it. So yeah, I'll be like showing you the song process. So what I'm doing right now, I'm just deleting all the baseline patterns because it'll still be saved. So I'm going to start this out with like an intro because that's what I usually started out. But since like you're like an artist, you can do whatever you would like to do. You can start out however you would like to. I'm just looking for a good way to start it out. That's always the tricky part as a producer. And this could probably be louder. Let's see, what could be good? Oh yeah, we're gonna start it out like this. And I'm just gonna save it. And then I'm gonna add like a verse or something. Actually, I'm gonna add like a transition. Another bass line and add like a transition thing to it. So it can be easier to follow along when it changes to a chorus or a verse. So let's find a transitioning sound. Or a SFX. I like that one. So I'm going to put this one right here. Name it transition. So yeah, this is gonna be like the intro right here. And this is gonna be like the verse or something. So let's see now. Ooh, I know a better way to help. I believe my like listeners and viewers and audience, I'm gonna try to color code it. So let's see, the intro can be the color. Let's go with, I don't know, green. The verse, I'll make it red, actually yellow. And then red can be the chorus. The yellow is going to be the verse and red can be the chorus. And the way you color code it, let's go to this square tool, like right, or from the right from the draw mode pencil. And it'll say Edit Mode Select Tool. Click that. Then like right click. Once it's selected, go to Change Color. And you should be able to change the color to whatever you like. Then click away from it and it'll become that color. And then click back to the draw mode to edit it. So yeah, this is going to be the chorus right here. So let me play it to see how it sounds. Yeah, hey, yeah, ATL stacking. What the fuck? Oh, oops. I guess I forgot. Let me try this again. I'm just gonna speed this up so whenever I go back it doesn't make the video longer than what it needs to be, but I'll bring it down to its original tempo when I'm done with the song. Oh, I know what can make this chorus way more interesting. Just to spice things up, I'm gonna go to that bell noise. Gonna click that, or go and open piano note roll. Select that, copy it. And I'm just doing this to make the chorus more interesting. Gonna go back to that same sound, paste it, and then do control down arrow to bring it down an octave. And I'm gonna place that and have it play in the chorus so it doesn't sound as repetitive. So let's see how this sounds. should I do? Should I have this played throughout the whole entire course? Should I add both of them? Or should I just have it play for that part? That's one of the tricky things about being a producer. Let's see. Ooh, I want to get even more fancier and creative by thinking outside of the box. That's always a good skill to have. So what I'm going to do is that same method I did before. Instead of going down an octave, I'm going to go up an octave and see how that sounds. So let's see. Yo, never mind. Yeah, that was a bad experiment. Let's bring this. I don't know. What could I do? I guess just play with it until I get a sound I like. Nah, that'll make the video too long. What could I do? Duh. Ooh, I got an idea. I can have it play less notes throughout the course so it can make the instruments or the background instruments shine out or do a spot more. So let's see if this works. Let's see if my theory works. If I have it play less notes, it'll make the chorus stick out even more. So let's see. Let's slow it down to its original tempo. And let me go back to the chorus. Yeah. I got an idea. Those few notes I do like, so I'm gonna keep that. Copy or cut paste. And then let's see. Gonna delete that. Put this here and make that go down an octave. Beautiful. There you go. So yeah, that's like the verse, intro, and chorus like process. But I'm just gonna add like I'll say another course or another verse and course to make it sound like more of a song, and then I'll have it all finished and then I'll upload it to YouTube. Yeah. Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. Okay. What? Yeah. Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. So I'm gonna play the whole entire beat again, and then after that, yeah, it's gonna be a wrap. I'm gonna post it to YouTube. ATL stacks. I just wanted to thank you guys for staying to the end, and I hope you guys like learned something from this. And yeah, this is ATL Stacks, and yeah, well, I'll catch you guys later. I hope.